Hello, I'm David from Siltide, and I'm going to show you how to use SiteBeam to test a website. Enter the address of the website you want to test and press go. You'll notice the box expanding with more options. Enter some keywords for products and services for this website into the first box and enter any locations in the second box. This gives SiteBeam a bit of information that it uses when running some of the SEO tests. I'll show you how that works a bit later on. The website I'm testing lists itself as a digital agency that does web design, so I'll add these as keywords. You'll notice that as I'm typing, beneath the box, SiteBeam will start listing websites. What it's doing is researching other websites with these same keywords and creating a list of sites to compare against. This website is for a company based in Helsinki, so we'll add this as a location. You can see that this list is being revised and showing a number of similar websites. SiteBeam will use these to compare with your site. If you want, you can edit this list and add a specific website to compare against, like maybe a competitor. You can also change the search engine that you want to include in the tests and add others. You can choose from Google, Bing or Yahoo, and choose if you want to use country-specific or global search. I'll leave it on the default, which is Google Global. Click to continue. You can now choose what type of report you want to run, and this depends on what information you want to find out. For now, we'll choose Complete Report. This includes all reports, but also takes the longest to run. You can also choose how many pages you want to test. For now, I'll leave it at 100, which should be more than enough. Reports can take a long time to run, so I'm going to let it email me when it's finished. You can press Test to start a report, but I'm going to show you one that's already finished. This colourful report first shows us some summary scores and picks out key points about this website. These might be things that it does really well and things that it doesn't do very well. The number shows a score out of 10 for each of these. You can click each summary for more information, or you can click on each of the tests at the side here. Each test has a score and also appears red for bad and green and blue for good. These summaries give you information at a glance. For example, you can see the accessibility report for this site, which in this case has good points but has picked up a broken link. Or you can see the marketing report, which tells us that this site is increasing in popularity and is linked to quite a lot on Twitter, but the site is rarely updated and doesn't do so well in search engines. The technology summary shows how well built the site is and any points that aren't so good. You can even click recommendations for a big long list of things you can do to improve your site, ordered by what we think would be most important. Here's the search ranking test. Earlier on, we entered some keywords and a location. SiteBeam uses those keywords and shows you how well this site scores for each term. It does this for the search engines we specified. We can see the number of results for each term and how far up the results this site is ranked. What we can do is look at the comparison tab to see which websites rank for these terms and see what this website has to compete against. So you can see that this website is doing really well for these terms. You can also check the spelling across your entire website with a spelling test. This shows you a list of words down the left which SiteBeam thinks are misspelt. Click each one and you'll see a preview of the word in context and which page it appears on. Many of these words might be company names or people, so you can add them to the dictionary so they won't show again. If you're running this report to make a presentation for clients, you can also click Presentation here. And SiteBeam will give you a full presentation focusing on all key points from the report, which you can export to PowerPoint to take with you. If you're interested in SiteBeam and want to try it out for yourself, you can sign up for our free trial at siltide.com/sitebeam.